be viewing the show Wednesday.
Those innocent eyes.
Hey Tokas, it's Chloe. Welcome back to my channel. Before we get started, you should have all my socials linked below. Anyways, today's video does include spoilers, so do not watch past this point if you have not seen the show Wednesday. However, it is trending, so I'm sure you guys have seen it. Today, I'm going to be reviewing it. For starters, I think Tim Burton is amazing for this idea. I feel like it was executed really well. I rate the show a 9 out of 10. Because it cannot beat The Summer I Turned Pretty, I'm sorry, but if you see my review, I love that show, Team Conrad. Anyway, I am Team Tyler, and I kind of want to make this video because I feel like this point that I have doesn't get spread around, and people just be like, oh my god, he's the Hyde, literally shut. Let me explain, please let me explain. Tyler is the Hyde because his mother was the Hyde. Tyler could not control it because he was groomed by, you know, Thornhill. He was groomed by her. That's the reality, is that Tyler was groomed by Thornhill. And so it is not Tyler's fault that he's the Hyde. He didn't control it. He can't control it. And Thornhill took advantage of him. And I think that is absolutely disgusting that that point is not made more. It was not his choice. Also, really fast, I do know Hunter is girly pop in real life. Go him. Whatever. Tyler, sorry. I'm watching George and Ginny season 2, and Hunter's in there, so I'm sorry. But anyways, I think that since Thornhill is dead, Wednesday can control him, and I feel like, not control him weirdly, but like control him from reaching out, and I feel like he could protect her using the Hyde ability, because there's a lot of people after Wednesday. I also feel like the show, the way that it was written with the slight romance plot, but then the Enid friendship and everything like that was just absolutely amazing. I don't like Xavier. I feel like they have absolutely no chemistry in the show, and I don't want to watch something with no chemistry. And Xavier is like head over heels over her. However, Xavier doesn't deserve him because she doesn't show any sort of love to him. She's not nice to him. I just don't see it working. I love Tyler so much because he was so nice to her, and I get it. He couldn't kill her because, you know, he needed her, but he's incredibly smart, and I feel like Wednesday needs someone who's not an airhead. Anyway, I also just wanted to say, why would he put in all this effort to date her if he was the Hyde? And I feel like he truly cares about her, because when you look at him see her, it's insane. Like, the dance scene, he put up with so much, and he got, you know, all, like, drenched and stuff, and he just, it was just such a cute moment. And Enid, she's such a sweetheart. I love her so much. She carries the show. Like, rainbows are not my thing. However, their friendship, and when they hugged in the last scene, I cried. Okay, I'm getting emotional, because, like, the show is just such a roller coaster. Also, I think that's kind of disgusting how men are still, like, literally obsessing over Jenna Ortega and saying all this sexual stuff, because, listen, even if she wasn't gay, nobody should be sexualizing a woman. Like, that's, it's disgusting. Please stop sexualizing her. No. And it's funny, because the people sexualizing her, she doesn't want them, so it's, like, embarrassing much, you know? Also, Uncle Fester, come on, Uncle Fester, iconic queen, love him. Uncle Fester is honestly one of my favorite characters, as long as Fang. The scene where Fang almost died, are you kidding? I almost cried over a hand. Like, girl, what? This show, amazing, amazing production, but my emotions were going everywhere. Another thing to mention is AJ. I love AJ. AJ is perfect for Enid. He was so sweet to her. He treated her how a woman is supposed to be treated, or anybody in general. But Enid's a woman, so. So, I just, like, loved him. I feel like he is so cool. He's very, I don't know, he's very different, and he gives that nice, really cool edge. Yeah. I just feel like the show is just such a great production, and honestly, when you hear about the backstory of her dad, I forgot the dad's name. But I think that's insane. Like, wow. Like, I knew how much they were in love, But seeing that he literally killed for her, literally was just like, and my standards are not him texting other girls. I'm hoping that people start accepting the fact that it wasn't Tyler's fault, because I know I keep bringing that up, but I just feel like it's not. And I know I tend to go for toxic guys. However, Tyler was not toxic to her one bit, and he was so sweet for her. Although when he was like, you're giving me mixed vibes, she literally never did anything that proved that she liked him. However, she chose him to kiss. Not Xavier, not anybody else. She chose Tyler. And honestly, they have so much chemistry. I think that it's both because, I don't know. Also, really fast, Jenna Ortega hasn't been proven to be gay. However, she's basically, like, someone pointed to, like, the flag and she was like, yeah, I am. So, yeah. I love this show so much and I hope that you guys enjoyed. I'm really praying that you guys only watch this if you have seen the show Wednesday, because I don't want to spoil anything. Also, I wore this dress because it reminded me of Wednesday. Shout out goes to the person on the screen. They left a nice comment. The username and profile picture are adorable. Anyways, thank you guys so much for all the support. We're really close to 8K, and I love you guys so much. I'll see you in the next video. Bye, Tocas.